Hello folks, this is Ayatan Ajha from InspireToRise.com and today we are going to unbox and review the Moto One Vision. So guys, let's first start with an unboxing for the same. This is the official box for the Motorola One Vision. Inside you get the smartphone. This is available in two colors. We had the bronze color and it looks pretty good. It is one of the first 21:9 aspect ratio display smartphones in India because the Sony smartphone hasn't launched yet. And now let's take a closer look inside the box. Inside the box, what else do you get? You get the SIM tray slot removal pin, you get the warranty card documentation, the TPU cover, and not too much else. On the inside, the pin is like this. It's a very different design. You get the fast charger on the inside for this smartphone, and you also get the USB Type-C cable, and there are no bundled earphones on the inside. Now let's talk about the build and design. So the phone is quite long because of the cinematic display, but it's still comfortable to hold and slim at 180 grams. It has a huge hole punch notch on the top left, so the hole punch is slightly bigger from a design perspective. And now if we talk more about few of the issues, I found that the hole punch causes slight light bleeding in the corner of the left hand side. But apart from that, the display is good enough. It's a 6.3 inch LTPS IPS LCD display, Full HD Plus, and it's not really 100% color accurate, but still good enough. It has 464 nits of maximum brightness. It's acceptable and the contrast is great. It's visible outside. And I personally felt that this display is pretty good for watching videos and a lot of other things. And this is one of the better smartphones out there for people who are really on the go watching a lot of videos. Availability of 21:9 content might be an issue, but apart from that, I felt that it's a great display for watching videos or stuff. And the phone wobbles a bit because of the camera sensor, which is protruding out from the back. At the back, you get the fingerprint sensor along with the dual tone LED flash. And it's an elongated smartphone, and there's the Android One branding at the back. It has got a fingerprint sensor in the Moto Dimple, which is really good, fast, accurate. Face unlock also works on this smartphone. And personally, I like the fact that the build and design is pretty good for a smartphone like this. At the bottom, there's the USB Type-C port along with the speaker grill and the microphone hole. At the top, there's a noise cancellation microphone along with the 3.5mm jack. And if we talk about a few other things, the chin at the bottom is slightly large. Now if we talk about the specifications, this device comes with the Exynos 9609 chipset, 4GB of RAM, 128GB of internal storage, which is fast but not really as fast as a UFS 3 storage, and it gets you 101 out of 128GB free. The benchmark performance was also above average, it was good. The internal read-write speed is higher than your normal eMMC storage, and you can play games like PUBG on HDR and Ultra on this smartphone, which was really surprising for me, and that's really good. And if you are gonna play PUBG for even long periods of time, the smartphone did not heat up much, so that was also something that I particularly liked. This device comes with a 3500 mAh battery, so the battery life does not really last long while you are gaming or doing some really heavy stuff, and I found that the gaming performance was really good for a smartphone like this. And when you are playing games, the whole notch area is just flattened out and the notch does not come into display. So that's a better way to deal with that situation, and I feel that it does not come in the way while you are gaming. And this particular gaming session went really strange as I was punching people who were shooting at me, and still I won. So now let's talk about the camera performance. This device comes with a 48MP Samsung GM1 sensor at the back. This pixel binning, f1.7 aperture, has OIS, PDF, and there's also a 5MP depth sensor. It has all of the custom Moto gestures like chop chop, twist, etc. And I personally found that the camera was good enough for your day-to-day usage, and the picture quality was definitely good. The kind of pictures that you would get from Gcam were possible from this camera's stock camera application, and I particularly like the fact that the pixel binning takes care of low light shots, and there's also a super night mode which works really good. So I found that for the price for which this device retails, the camera is definitely superlative and gets you some really good shots. It shoots 4K videos at 30 frames per second with OIS, and the sharpness felt average. Rest of the things felt great. The exposure control on the front camera wasn't really that good. The front camera is a 25MP one, which I personally found good for a lot of selfies, etc. But in videos, it felt a little bit underwhelming. Apart from that, this smartphone comes with a fast fingerprint sensor, as I've already told you. There's a single speaker setup at the bottom, but it was loud and excellent. It has hybrid micro SD card slot, USB OTG, has support for NFC, lots of sensors. Only the battery life and the big hole punches few of the issues that I would say that are present with this smartphone. But apart from that, it's an Android One smartphone, has a lot of good things going on for it. And I feel that the 0 to 38% battery charging in 30 minutes is something that would mitigate the lower battery life for a lot of people. But the 3500 mAh battery does feel underwhelming for a lot of people. And I would say that if you want a bigger battery smartphone, go for something else. But if you want a great smartphone with a cinematic display, good performance and good camera, this may be the choice for you under the 20k price bracket. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button and do subscribe to Inspire to Rise for more awesome tech videos like this one. And guys, no matter what you do, stay inspired to rise.